If you ever wanted to tween a model's position, you probably realize that there isn't a position property for models. You can only change the model's position, or with the appropriate name, pivot, with pivot to function. However, this function is not a property, which means we can't directly tween this. There are some more ways of solving this problem. However, the one I will use today is with a CFrame value. We can connect an event to listen for CFrame value's value changes, and then we can pivot the door to the new location. This will allow us to use tween service on the CFrame value, and that will also apply the door. But first I will set a primary parts for this model. This isn't necessary for this method, but I recommend setting a primary part, just to visually make sure where your door pivot is. I also added a frame value to my door. In the script, firstly I set a first value to the CFrame value. This script is from a game I develop, so yours don't need to be same. But make sure to set the value to first pivot of your model. As you can see, the way I use my door is with tweens. I have two tweens I initialize at first, and then I play them for closing and opening. Currently it changes this union part, however I will change it to door.value, so it will change the CFrame value's value. I will also change my function here for tweens. And lastly, we need to add an event for the CFrame value. This event will use pivot to function on the door whenever the value changes. This is the script after some error fixes. I had some type errors, I fixed these lines later. Also this line, since we use a different position value now, if we test the game right now, we can see that when I use this proximity prompt, the whole door moves up. What happens here is the CFrame value gets tweened to our desired value, and when that value gets updated, change signal also fires and pivots the model to the CFrame. Just to give you a visual explanation with the output, I ran a command which listens to the changes in the value. The door gets moved to all these positions as soon as they change, so we have a smooth tweened animation. That was it for this video. Hope you understood. See you in another one.